Hi everybody, welcome to the Merchants of Gold 2.0, the style of the times. In this video, we will examine how trends are created and how they originate. Is it the high power marketing or fashion executive, or the everyday teen on the go? Sit back as we answer the question, who are the true merchants of cool?
Trends are usually made by celebrities and different music artists and top fashion designers. Depending on your social group, that's how you usually build your own style, and that's the trend you follow. So if you're into underground rap music, you usually tend to dress similar to how they dress and have a lifestyle, like how they live. If you're really into pop culture, you pay attention to the different reality shows like Kim Kardashian and Britney Spears, different celebrities in pop culture. If you're more of an artsy person, maybe you base yourself off of feeling, you just dress however you feel for that day. It all depends on the social group that you're in. That's how you usually decide your trends. As for fashion designers getting their ideas, I know that some like to watch people in the street and see how they interact and they get inspiration off of that. Some fashion designers just make up something that they just feel is the next big thing, is the next fashion forward item and that everyone needs to have. Usually society just based off what the fashion trend is by the top designers. So if they say that this year's color is orange, then I bet that every designer under them and every clothing line that isn't as high end will have plenty of things that are orange. Orange skirts, orange hats, everything.
So, who decides what's cool? Who truly decides what's in and what's out of style? According to the feedback loop, executives and creative managers venture out into the world to look for the new, coolest things that teenagers are into before it becomes mainstream and popular. These people are called cool hunters. Once the newest trend is available for the general teenage population, the trend originators then move on to the next undiscovered thing.
Okay, I feel like fashion is definitely recycled. Just considering like different articles of clothing like jean jackets, jean shirts, leggings, colorful leggings, bodysuits, all those different things. Living in California as well as Atlanta, there's really a big gap in between just the way that people dress. Here it's more of like a southern feel, very chill, more stuff. And then more in California, it's really like retro and vintage. Street style, I would say definitely a lot of different colors, and people are bringing back like high-waisted jeans, high-waisted shorts, and things of that nature. Different fashion icons like Tyra Banks and different movies, Grease and Footloose, are definitely things that I see when I look at fashion today. So,
1, 2, 3, 4.
Hipsters or hypebeasts? Okay, so what exactly are hipsters and what are hypebeasts? According to popular opinion, my interviews, a hipster is a person who is along the first lines of people to receive or to act on a certain trend. Then, as soon as the trend becomes popular, they turn their nose and move on to the next undiscovered thing. Okay, so a hypebeast is one who jumped from trend to trend solely because this was popular at the moment. They have all the coolest and most expensive clothes and shoes just so they can be in the midst of the trend. So what do you think? Annoying or respectable?
Empire. Future.
Fish tail in that parking lot, leave magic. Two bad bitches and I got them out of magic. The way I made the world disappear, call it magic. Sipping on the purple and the yellow, drinking magic. Fish tail in that parking lot, leave magic. Two bad bitches and I got them out of magic. The way I made the world disappear, call it magic. Sipping on the purple and the yellow, drinking magic. Voila, magic, voila. Magic, voila, magic, voila, magic. Bitch telling out the parking lot, leave magic.
If you don't hear that drop, then this is not a true exclusive.
On my way to Aspen's, I forgot to do my task.
Hold on.
Call my accountant, he gon' make it do magic. Had to get a driver jet to drop me at the airport. Way I smoke the blunts, man, I burn them.
Clothes are very important, especially shoes. My favorite type of shoes are Jordans. I like Jordans because they're nice, comfortable, stylish, trendy. My favorite type of Jordan probably have to be the Space Jams. I like those because they're black, they're nice, they go with everything. Pretty much clean shoe. Jordans are cool because Michael Jordan's like the best player ever, and he wore these shoes while he played, so they're cool, but only numbered Jordans, and only select number Jordans, not team Jordans, because we don't do team Jordans. They're not, he never wore those. Yeah, shoes are just important. You gotta have them if you wanna be cool.
So, we've talked about how trends are created and how the feedback loop facilitates and drives the creation and marketing of trends to everyday teenagers. We've examined fashion from its gritty discovery on the streets to how it becomes inspiration for high-power marketing firms and expensive fashion houses. I hope you've enjoyed and learned a lot, too. Bye.